Wheeler twisting away from Doughty. Back to the blue line. Josh Morrissey, he'll try to walk away from Arvidsson. Shoots! Put it wide. And it comes off the skate, it looks like. Poking at it. Score! Shankly jammed it off the goaltender. Somebody put it in. And it's 1-0 Winnipeg.
Doesn't matter who. And look at that escapability off the strong wall as he's got Arvidsson chasing him. And off the flat wall, look at the dig. The second effort is Mark Scheifele just won't go away. Three blue shirts in and around the net. It may be Josh Morrissey's, but they don't care. The big thing is they have now scored a 5-on-5 goal. That's the first time in quite some time.
Wheeler, the pass, a good one. Morrissey, time for DeMello, shoots! And that is blocked and hit Campari. DeMello again. Wheeler pushed by Edler. Two men get on him. Shankly comes over to help. And time for Morrissey to walk. Morrissey shoots, scores! Two in a row for Josh Morrissey. 2-0 Winnipeg.
So a shot and a shot block. LA's one of the better teams at doing that. But look at the work on the half wall. A puck recovery. Nice job from Blake Wheeler. And then they get the puck from side to side, and nothing but time from Josh Morrissey. Now with two on the evening, and this really efficient power play that Kings goes to work for the first time.
Downey faked the shot to Miala. Cross ice, scored just like that. 6 seconds into the power play, Kopitar cuts the lead in half. It's 2-1.
Boy, that sure didn't take long. And, you know, in the pre-scout and just watching games from the LA Kings leading up to this, everything going right. They win the face-off clean and a seam to the back door as you see the fadeaway from Kopitar. And that's just a lane you can't give up. But the Kings have so many different guys on the ice that are threats. You can't blame Hellebuck.
Morrison cuts away from Arvidsson. Shankly had to wait as Fetalainen was in the Kings zone. And now Shankly will put his head up. Make his way forward. Gives the puck to Kyle Connor with a shot. He scores! What a shot by Kyle Connor! And it's 3-1 Winnipeg. I don't know how he found the room, but he did. And that's 27 for number 81.
He hasn't got the geometry working for him. A nice little dish. Kicks it wide. Goes to the net. Does Mark Scheifele. That opens up the space for Kyle Connor. And they talk about ringing the bell. He rings the doorbell, but he kicks the door off the hinges as he shoots it up by the chin of Copley. And the sharpshooter sends one precisely where he wants it, off the bar and in.
We're up by a pair with 11 left in this second period. Metalainen struggled with it. Picked up by Kempe. He'll leave it. Now the pass from Byfield to Edler. Shoots and score! That was deflected. It beat Hellebuck, and once again, it's a one-goal game.
This is a shot from Alexander Edler. I think this one ends up going off of Kopitar. You're right, Dan, and has ice. And there's a good job filling a shot lane. And sometimes, you what? You're in the right places. You make the right play away from the puck, and still a little bit of bad luck that goes the wrong way. Oh, it's actually the stick of Kopitar. This is something I think he meant to do. Goaltender is Blake Wheeler for any kind of second chance.
Now Doughty shoots, score! And it's Kopitar with the redirect and the hat trick. And we're tied at 3. Two terrific tips by the Kings captain.
But they have a way of getting there and being dangerous. A face-off win, look at that. He goes straight to the net, and just a little bit too much time and too much space for an elite two-time Stanley Cup champion. Hand-eye coordination off the charts, and that's his fifth career hat-trick for Anze Kopitar.
Morrissey shoots it, and that is fought off by Copley, who hasn't been razor sharp tonight. The Connor goal, as nice as the shot it was, probably should have been stopped. Jersey falls. There's a drive by Stenlund, and he scores! Kevin Stenlund is first in 13, and the Jets have regained the lead.
And he took full advantage. Nice job down low. This Barron line has been so good. Off the cycle, winning battles, build a wall, and look at that. Nothing but time and space, and Binks, top corner. He had no shots against the Islanders. He had 4 in the game prior to that against the Avalanche. And you know what? You talk about Lowry, you talk about Stenlund. These guys have earned opportunities. They haven't had opportunities. They haven't been able to close.
Off the draw, comes back to Durzi. Dano. Pretty good pass, cross ice. Durzi again, shot, blocking away. Hellebuck came way out. Dano threw it through, tipped again. That time by Arvidsson, and this time stopped by Hellebuck.
good second effort on that shift from Mark Scheifele, who Kyle Connor keeps it in barely, and Scheifele wins a puck battle to keep the puck in the offensive zone, which is where we stand.
Great pass, Scheifele, what a stop by Conley, as he got a piece of it. Zamber put it right in the front of the net. Doughty. Watch out, loose puck. Chopped out, Lowry will carry it in. Trailing is Stenlund. Kevin Stenlund scores! Stenlund, that's shorthanded, and it's 5-3.
You had to wonder about Kevin Stenlund with the chances that he's created. This is a big one, an impactful one. Shorthanded pressure up the ice from Adam Lowry like he's done so many times in the past, and he hits Stenlund right in the strike zone. That's not an easy one. You wait for it to come across your body on a strong side one-timer.
Kopitar, oh, look out, that was up the skate of Pionk. Hellebuck had an eye on it. Lift the head glove down by Lowry. He's played a strong game here tonight for Winnipeg. Pass ahead, Brunstrom. Here comes Kopitar, shoots, scores! The second career four-goal game for Andrei Kopitar.
But you can't give that type of time and space to an elite player who's feeling it tonight. Four goals in the game. He's got all of it for his team, and right there, the showdown with Connor Hellebuck, and he goes top blocker, and how about that? Skates into it full force. The big man, two-time Selke Trophy winner, is all about the offense tonight. Puck roll.
Scheifele off the rush with a drive, and a shot stopped by Copley. Scheifele looking for it now. He finds it. Back for Josh Morrissey. Played it to the open corner smartly. He didn't have an option other than that. The feed for Lazon. A bit of a thorn in the side of the Jets tonight. And Velarde gets behind his man right in, scores! Sandberg wiped out. Velarde has his 19th, and we are tied at 5.
Lazon. Velarde, pardon me. Up the ice. And he missed 10 games earlier with injury. This is a man that can shoot the puck and score, and he doesn't make a mistake here off of a forecheck. Sandberg slips, goes down.
Arvidsson gets there, a bouncing puck. Josh Morrissey turning, shoots through a crowd. Here's a chance, Scheifele denied by Conley, his biggest stop of the night. He lopes into the zone, just gliding with it now for Doughty. Drew Doughty, out front is Kopitar. Doughty looks for him, and he's stopped by Hellebuck. Doughty, out of gas perhaps, pass for Kopitar, and that will bring the overtime period to an end. Connor 1-for-1 this year, 43% for his career. 0-for-1 this year, I should say. He'll come in rather quickly. Connor, lots of moves, and what a stop by Copley at the last second with the left leg. Connor had him dead to right.
Are you kidding me? You're right. He beat him, and Copley didn't give up on the play as he just ever so subtly lifts that left leg. Oh, man. Kyle Connor can't believe it.
He'll cruise to the slot, scores. Well, Kempe gets the first goal in this shootout.
Kempe just does a good job there on the corner. He'll slide this one right on the ice. 5.
36% for his career. He needs it. He'll come quickly. Blake Wheeler stops. He stopped, and the game is over. The Kings come back from a 2-goal deficit and beat the Jets in a shootout.